Hello, comic book fans. Here's Earl Grey with a second video about Lorenzo Mattotti. I did a video some years ago about these three books here, The Man at the Window, Fire, and Flüster, however you translate this into English, maybe Whisper or something. That one was written by Jerry Krumsky. But I've bought since then a ton of books by him, and I just have to show you these ones here. Maybe start with Labyrinth or Labyrinth. This one was also written by Jerry Krumsky and is a bit similar to these Fire and Flüster books here. This is the German edition, and it shows the signature art style of Lorenzo Mattotti. He draws, or rather paints, with oil pastels that he smears on the paper. And here he added some ink lines to it, but he is very fluent with this mix of techniques, maybe colored pencils as well. And he mixes them up to some combination of expressionistic art styles with some cubistic influences, some panels really look like they were conceived by Georges Braque or Picasso, or however. I could drop a dozen names of famous artists, but this wouldn't eventually fit the art style of Lorenzo Mattotti, because he's really unique. And especially in the comic world, his stuff is instantaneously recognizable as Lorenzo Mattotti's art. So this story here I really, or this collection of short stories, I really enjoyed, because these are really fun comic stories in which a lot of stuff is happening in the outside world, which is not always the case with Lorenzo Mattotti's art or comics. Pretty typical is rather this inner monologue of some guys who, yeah, you could say they're a bit whiny, as it is the case in The Crackle of the Frost. That was written by George Centenaire. He is George Centenaire, an Argentinian guy who wrote one favorite comic of mine, The Adventures of Dieter Lumpen. But he works as a psychotherapist as well, and this shows here in this story big time. Here we have the man himself, Lorenzo Mattotti. Because this here, this book here, The Crackle of the Frost, is, yeah, psychotherapy in comic book form, I would say. It was first published in a magazine for the German newspaper FAZ, Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung, one of the better or best newspapers, even if it's a bit pretentious, and maybe you can say it's a German New Yorker. But they have a comic expert, Andreas Platthaus, who really, yeah, he knows his stuff, and his comic reviews usually are a joy to read, especially when you compare it to the rubbish that is written by other journalists about comics in Germany. So this was published in this colored magazine, some sort of companion to the actual newspaper, and on each page there were 8 panels, but here they reprinted it in this fashion. And you can see these are very colorful panels who depict the inner journey of the main guy, who is, yeah, it's hard for me a bit to relate to him, because he's, yeah, one of these guys who isn't able to take his responsibility in life, and loses his girlfriend because she wants a child of him, and he doesn't want and but regrets it, and whine, whine, whine. On the other hand, this comic here is a journey through his emotions, through the evolution of his inner self, and when a comic is able to achieve that, it's really great. Especially when you look at these fantastic panels that really add up to a story. But again, it's more the story of his inner psyche, and even if there are some autobahn stations are or roads and streets are just depicted, but it relates to the story, of course. Look at these panels here. Wonderful illustrations. But, of course, not your usual fare of comic art. That's obviously true for all the stuff from Lorenzo Mattotti. He is a comic world of his own, I think. This one here translates maybe to letters from a distant time. And it's a collection of short stories as well. Like the Labyrinth book. Wonderful use of these pastels and how you can depict transition with all pastels. Sometimes crystal clear and sometimes very atmospheric. Wonderful book, even though the stories are in this book here are more atmospheric sketches. Than anything else. Wonderful, wonderful book. So, this one here is interesting as well. The Raven. With illustrations from Mattotti for some musical of the great Lou Reed. Who did? This was this premiered in this musical premiered in Hamburg, actually here in Germany, and really close to our home. But in 2000 or so, when we lived somewhere else. So, that's a musical by Lou Reed about the stories from Edgar Allan Poe. And for this catalog, he worked together with Mattotti. That Mattotti can do the art for this catalog. And this here is really more rough art, I would say, for Mattotti. Sometimes, some places it's the typical crystal clear and very well planned out and mapped out art. Some art here is really rough for Lorenzo Mattotti, and I would say the equivalent for a very dirty guitar riff or Lou Reed or the Velvet Underground. Especially the title illustration, when I can find it here, I can show it here, the title illustration for The Raven. That's not so typical in his very sketchiness, loose sketchiness for Lorenzo Mattotti. So, this one here is a big art book with oil pastels. I will show you them in a minute. But maybe this here is the most interesting book here for all of you, because it's a recent tome from Fantagraphics. Galandia, and it shows another side of Lorenzo Mattotti, that you can enjoy in this older book that I've shown you before, The Man at the Window as well, here, because that's black and white art. This older one here, he is, it's a bit lighter with the lines. In this book here, he's really heavily on hatching and sometimes cross-hatching and doing structures with your line work, creating worlds in piling lines and onto each other and developing structures that evolve to beings that float in the sky or in the water. And it's this fantastic fantasy world of Galandia with these nice guys and girls who live in this land here, and it's almost a little paradise where all they jump around nude and have their lives and get their children and yeah, it's a simple and beautiful life where they live in peace and harmony until some demons arrive. But it's I don't want to say too much about it. It's a very fantasy, fairy tale-ish world with lots of imagination and very quick read. Actually, if you just go to for the story, you can flip around these pages. There's not too much text in it, and you get the story pretty quick, and it's not this whining around. These are really tough characters actually, very relatable, nice guys and girls, and even though they have to deal with some strange, bizarre stuff here. That's an oracle in the mountains, which is depicted, of course, very impressive, in a very impressive manner. As you can see, the guys liked it. So, I breezed through this book here in, I don't know, 2-3 hours, which is very fast, at least for me, and especially if you consider that this book here is really thick. That book here is really nicely made. And since I mention in my last videos always the paper quality, I have to say that this paper here, this is fantastic as well. It's matte paper, thick paper, and the binding is pretty good. The binding is good. Really, really good. Yeah, I think this book here can be wholeheartedly recommended by myself. And this has almost some biblical quality, like the Last Judgment or so. If you think of the Michelangelo painting, where for an example, where the good can rise to heaven and the bad will be pulled down to the earth, or the hell. Yeah. As you can tell, it's a late night edition, so I ramble a bit. But here we go for the real fat art cover, art book here, with covers, illustrations, and a lot of stuff published by one publisher, Logos. They did at least one other book that I've bought and it is on the way to my doorstep, but I haven't. It's not, it hasn't arrived yet. About his fashion illustrations. I'm not the biggest fashion expert or really interested in fashion, but when fashion is drawn and painted by Matotti, of course I am. So, but these are here just pastels for different projects in a huge book. And fortunately, I'm very thankful for that. It's not of these usual art books where the art is spoiled with all the remarks when they're on each page you can read, okay, pastel on paper and the size of it. Okay, the size usually is interesting, but when I have books with art on each page you have the remark that it is oil on canvas or something like that. Even if a painter has never done something different than oil on canvas, it is written on each page and in this size here, and then the painting has to be smaller. So it's a good thing that these reproductions were printed as big as they can in this book here. Thinking about it, this is actually the, I believe, the cover illustration for the second, that fashion tome. So I'm curious how many pictures will be, turn out to be double. This would be then a art book double dipping of sorts. Anyhow. Let's wait and see. For the most part, of course, as far as I've seen these here, these are illustrations for different projects. Even one or two illustrations from The Raven, the Poe Lou Reed project here. The binding here is pretty good, even though I don't know if there is some split here between the paper and the ribbon here is in development. I'm very anxious about that, but I think that can be repaired pretty easily. And this book here, otherwise, is a pure joy. Even though it's, of course, not a comic. Yeah. Lorenzo Matotti is, I think, more a guy for these more pretentious magazines like the New Yorker or, in Germany, the Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung. So I think this is an illustration for the New Yorker as well. Beautiful, ain't it? Yeah, now I just could flip through this whole book here. And I would enjoy it, you would enjoy it, but maybe you should look for yourself to get this book here, because it's really worth it. Matotti works, pastels. So, yeah, that was what I wanted to show you. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.